click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see demultiplexer. Demultiplexer is a reverse operation of a multiplexer, where multiplexer we choose many to one. In demultiplexer we choose from one to many. That means data input will be one and that input will be connected to one of the output present. So let's see what is demultiplexer is. Demultiplexer also called as a decoder because the one input will be connected to the one of the different output according to the select line. It has a one input, n outputs and m select inputs. A demultiplexer performs the reverse operation of a multiplexer, that is it receives one input and distributes it over several output. At a time, only one output line is selected by the select lines and the input is routed to the selected output line. Now how this routing procedure takes place, that we will see by using the block diagram of demultiplexer. So this is the block diagram of a demultiplexer, where we have one data input, one enable line, that is a strobe. Here we have a G bar, that means active low will be considered as an active high. So this should be always low so that 0 will be taken as a 1 and demultiplexer will work. We have a different output. So here outputs are n. So n number of outputs and one input, and select line will be denoted by m, where the relation of n and m is equal to n is equal to 2 raised to m. So if output is equal to 4, m should be equal to 1. That means there should be one select line to choose the n is equal to 4. So according to that, we have a different types of a multiplexer. 1 is to 2 demux, 1 is to 4 demux, 1 is to 8 demux and 1 is to 16 demux. So we can discuss one by one how this demultiplexer will work, how the input data can be forwarded to that particular output by using select line. So here we have a 1 is to 2 demux, where data input is equal to 1. Output lines are equal to 2, so we have n is equal to 2, and for n is equal to 2, m is equal to 1. So it is called as a 1 is to 2 because 1 is an input, so 1 is to 2 demultiplexer. Now as I said, for a strobe, if G bar is equal to 1, it will take it as a 0 because G bar is nothing but it is taking G and inversion is equal to G bar. So if you provide 1, it will give you G bar is equal to 0, and if it is 0, it will be equal to 1. So your G bar should be equal to 0, then it will take as a 1. So for 1, that is if G bar is equal to 1, it will take it as a low, and demux, irrespective of what is the select line, your output will remain 0 0. That's why strobe should be equal to 0. If strobe is equal to 0, it will produce an output according to the select line. Now let's see for S0 is equal to 0. Now here S0 denotes that it should be goes to the 0 line. Again here also 0 represents binary 00 and 1 represents binary 01. So if it consists of S is equal to 0, 0 is nothing but in decimal also we called it as a 0. So your data input should be connected to Y0 line. So data input will be go for the Y0 line. Y1 will remain as 0. Similarly, if select input S0 is equal to 1, it will select Y1 line. That means D in will go to the Y1. So your D in information will go to the Y1 line, that this output line. Whereas for Y0, it will remain as a 0. This is how data can be forwarded to that particular line. Now let's see how 4 is to 1 demultiplexer work. So here we have 1 is to 4 demux, where data input is equal to 1 and we have a 4 output lines. Now depending of the different select lines, our output will be produced. So if G bar is 1, irrespective of what is the S0 and S1, output will be 0. If strobe is equal to 0, output will be produced according to the select line. So in first case, select line will be 00. 00 represents the decimal. This is a binary format and this is the decimal format. So 00 represents 0. So your output will be directed to Y0. So here Y0 is equal to D in, and Y1, Y2, Y3 will remain at 0. Similarly, if it is 0, 1, it will be forwarded to 1. That is represented by Y1. So your D in will be forwarded to Y1. So here you can see D in is for Y1 and Y0, Y2 and Y3 will remain at a 0 position. If you have a 1, 0 which represents binary 2, decimal 2 is represented by Y2, so data will be forwarded to output line Y2. Similarly, for 1, 1, it represents decimal 3, so my data will be represented by output line Y3. So here you can see D in is produced accordingly to that particular output line depending on the select line. Likewise, you can design demultiplexer for 1:8, 1:16, 1:32, 1:128, and so that only your number will be, that should be in 2^m format. That means this n number will be only represent that should be 2^ that power. So 2^2, 2^4, 2^3, 2^6, 2^5, and so that this number is allowed, and you can use the demultiplexer. You can design the demultiplexer accordingly. I hope you have understood demultiplexer. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Do subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you so much.